This is a species of Commiphorus africanus. In the Maasai, it's known as Old Temwai. It's very useful for the Maasai. When you do like this, it oozes liquid, which is very useful for the skin. Like, it cures skin problems, and also for the Maasai, they use it as a toothpaste in brushing. That is. And these are some of animals' bones. Some are fossilized and some are not fossilized. This is not fossilized. You can see it's very easy to carry.
Is it original?
Yeah, these are original bones. Unlike to that one, try to carry that.
How old is this one?
Probably could be the age of this layer, which is around 1.8 million years ago.
This is a point 1.8 million years old. And if I drop it, I lose everything I have.
So it has attained all the minerals from this fossilized.
This is not an original picture.
It's not an original picture. Yeah.
I think Tanzania invited for camera 3.6 million years ago.
That was impossible. So there was a lake, and you can see humans have actually captured their meal. And you know, they did not have these sharp stone tools or technology in hunting. So the technique was to chase an animal towards the lake. You know, there's mud, sand. So an animal will get stuck in the mud. So they'll capture it and take it under the trees, which is supposed to be this environment. And they'll consume it and later sleep on the top of the trees. That's why we have so many researchers mostly interested in being the state of layer number two, where they've been finding more zebras, wildebeest ones, which are expected to be the animals that were hunted by humans.
An dieser Stelle wurde der Homo habilis 1,75 Millionen Jahre vor Christus gefunden. Beziehungsweise, ich fange nochmal von vorne an. An dieser Stelle wurden die Überreste des Homo habilis, der ca. 1,75 Millionen Jahre vor Christus habe, im Jahre 2006 gefunden. Er stellt damit nach der Ausgrabungsstätte, die wir eben gesehen haben, die zweitälteste Ausgrabungsstätte in diesem Tal dar, die eine Wiege der Menschheit ist.